Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Rachel of Gathered Plans. So I had to redo this entire voiceover because I was not feeling it last night. I kind of felt like I was slurring over my words because I was just so tired after a long work day and a long workout session. So I was totally drained. But I'm using this absolutely beautiful kit called Wildflower from Two Little Bees. If you guys remember my stories, a couple of weeks ago I shared that I spilled water on the original kit and Maria was so kind and sweet and she had sent me another one. So thank you, Maria, if you're watching. I really appreciate you. And she was really sweet. There's actually a really cool surprise at the end of this, so stay tuned and hopefully you enjoy watching this plan with me. I love and adore how the spread turned out. It is so good. I don't want to toot my own horn, but like toot toot, seriously, I'm obsessed with how the spread turned out. Probably one of my all-time favorite spreads. And also because this was a very special week for me. This was actually the week that I went to Georgia and I met Alicia of Sadie Stickers for the first time. We had spent the weekend together and it was just a really, really nice vacation. Small little trip, kind of like a staycation at her place. Obviously not a staycation for me because I left, but kind of like a staycation for her. And it was just really cool to see everything in real life and to meet her finally. We have gotten super close and she's one of my closest friends in this community. And she's just super awesome and amazing. I'm sure you guys know about her shop already. She's always in my hauls and I use her kits. I've been using her kits for a long time and I have been drooling over her shop since I first found this community, but I was still a poor college student. So the fact that it has come this far where I actually have met her in real life, spent time with her and her family. Her baby Emma is the sweetest and cutest. And it was just such a great time. She's such a cool person. And she works very, very hard. So Alicia, I know you're watching. Just know that I love you and I appreciate you. And you are super cool. So anyways, enough of mushy gushy because she's probably cringing. If you're watching, I hope you're cringing. anyways, so I really wanted to use this kit because there's a little suitcase in one of the full boxes. And oh, before I proceed, I just want to share this little snippet here. I actually love when I like stop to do like Instagram videos and share stuff on Instagram too. And I guess it kind of shows you like in real life how much work is actually a part of being a YouTuber and someone that is, you know, on Instagram and shares their spreads and is active on there and blah, blah, blah. So I just wanted to share that. I thought that was really cute. So obsessed with how these day covers turned out. And you guys, I channeled my inner Tay. Tay, yes, giving me all the life because literally I see how she does this, but she does it where it's just very like minimal. Like she'll have some floral, like foiled floral and colored floral on some date covers. She might leave some empty. She might only do like the left or the right side. You guys get the gist. I'm sure you guys watch her because she's amazing. But I just couldn't get with how sparse it looked. I felt like I wasn't doing it justice. So I kept going back and forth and just adding more and more and more. And I am obsessed. I feel like this is truly like my style coming to life. And I love how this turned out. It is so pretty. It's really cool to kind of take on other people's styles and get inspired by them, but then make it your own. And that's what really, really makes this super special and super cool. And you can just put your own twist to stuff. So as you can see here, Lauren was saying how she admired how much work and like dedication I was putting into cutting up those individual dots from Honey Inked. And let me tell you, the day covers took so long. So long. Those dots alone took forever. But I'm super out of frame here and love what I did here. I am obsessed with this month section. I used the Polaroid from Miss and Meow and the cute little outfit deco. The May script is from Letters to Apollo. The accents and the dot banner are from Honey Inked and this star is from Sadie Stickers. Love, love how that turned out. Probably my favorite way I marked the month section to this day. So good. And I don't know, like I tried not to put any pressure on myself in this, but it truly just like was so easy because there were so many florals. I actually ended up pulling one of the deco sheets from the Jackson Pepper kit collab that I have with Lena, and it was just really cool to pull in larger florals, and I felt like I was missing that because I really have so much fun playing with larger florals, and that's all because of Lena of Jackson Pepper. She has really pushed me out of my comfort zone any and every time I've used her kits where I use her large deco and I just cut it up and have so much fun. But like I was saying before, this is just such a perfect kit to mark traveling because of the suitcase. I love the like, this could be like a really good spring or summer kit, to be honest with you, because there's so many butterflies and florals, but you could use this anytime for spring or summer to mark traveling. It is just so beautiful. It's light and airy. It's super floral. And, you know, as you guys know, floral is trending like crazy right now. So all of my trims are from Sadie Stickers. And I've been really enjoying just using trims for headers for the second and third row. I feel like it gives me a lot more space because headers can take up more space because of the height. And I wanted to tie in the trim that I used in the sidebar as well. All right, so if I missed anything in the sidebar, please just let me know and I'll be happy to let you guys know where it's from. Okay, again, most of my trims are from, actually, if not all of my trims are from Sadie Stickers, as well as all of the flourishes that I try to pull in every day. The accents are mostly from Honey Inked, with the exception of some of the stars that are from Sadie Stickers. This sticker to mark that I uploaded a haul, that is from Planning World. I haven't seen Yuan post anything new, so I think she's still active, like her shop is still, you know, open and stuff, but I just haven't really seen her active on Instagram, so just wanted to preface by saying that. I hope all is well, but I just want to say, like, I really miss her, so I hope that she comes back soon. The Flourish again is from Sadie Stickers. This is a mini or volume one lace box from Bloom Paper Studio. The pen cup is from White Deer Stationery. To just mark that, I made some, or I decorated my tabs for my pocket planner. And all of the dotted foiled lines are from Sadie Stickers. I do like using them to like close off where I cut the florals, just to kind of give it like an end and to cover my cut marks because it looks ratchet sometimes. So all right, so I really did not enjoy how I marked jamming out to Justin Bieber here. So I've been really, really enjoying his most recent albums. And I'm just, it's like a whole vibe, you know, it's just a whole vibe. It's been really cool and chill. And what I did was cut out the headphones that was a part of the podcast icon from Crafts by Towie. By the way, if you're watching this right now, she does have a $2 Tuesday with some new volumes up and some really cute, like, I think it's like back to school stuff, super adorable, so be sure to check that out. The box I used at the bottom of Mondays for Missing Me Out and like the floral cluster is from Letters to Apollo. Okay, so if not all, most of my icons are from White Deer Stationery and Crafts by Towie. And I think I only pulled in that one from Planning World on Monday. So on Tuesday, I used a beautiful doily circle from Alyssa's Craft Shop. I really, really love these. They're like the perfect circle size. They're so, so good. I'm able to write like three things in there and it just doesn't take up the full width of the column. And it's just a really great height and width. I don't know. She did a great job. I know I'm like being super extra with explaining, just okay. I also tried to pull in dot banners every day just to kind of tie in what I did in the sidebar. I've been trying really hard to be more intentional. So I'm just gonna get sidetracked here, but if I missed anything, just ask me below and I'll talk about it. But I really want to like be more minimal. Gosh, I just want to go through my collection and really just purge a lot of stuff I haven't been using and like pass it on, because I feel like I've just been grabbing the same things and I'm just enjoying it, like simplifying my collection, because you know I know what I love and I like, and I just keep going and gravitating towards them, and I just need to kind of simplify because I've been super overwhelmed with my collection recently and it's kind of pushing me away from like not wanting to use my stuff because I just have so much stuff now. Let me know if you can kind of relate, like just having a lot of something and it's overwhelming and it kind of scares you. I feel that way. It's just a lot, and putting things away gets too much, and I'm not in the mood sometimes especially because like I do YouTube, so I film a haul and then I have like a whole stack of stuff I haven't even put away and I'm just like overwhelmed. And yeah, it's a whole thing. It's definitely something that I need to just like deal with mentally, obviously, but it's just something that I wanted to share with you guys because I've actually spoken to a couple of my friends in the community that feel the same way a little bit. And it's even more work, I think, when you do YouTube videos as well. But I can only imagine too, like if you just plan for fun and your whole desk is filled with stuff, it's like putting it away is a whole job. It is a chore. Like it's so much work. It gets so messy. And you know, like setting up to like film something else, it's like I have to go and clean up and do all of this. It's so much work. So I just wanted to like say that. So I shared on my Instagram stories today that I just wanted to say thank you to those that make YouTube videos that I, you know, enjoy and love watching, because trust me, Sis, I'm right there with you. I get it. I appreciate the hard work that you put in. Know that you're recognized and you're awesome. So thank you to those that make YouTube videos and know how much work goes into this, because I just want you to feel appreciated. There should be like a YouTube creator day, you know? And this iPhone is upside down. Good job, Rachel. You're so smart. It's funny. I'm like in a mood today. Okay, I totally breezed through Tuesday and Wednesday, but I also wanted to tie in more of the mini mandalas, and I was inspired by Tay because she hauled some mini mandalas from Hun Inked. I kind of tucked them behind the large floral on the bottom of Tuesday, and I just love how like that classic mandala like design looks peeping out of the florals. It just looks so, so good. All right, if you want to know where the stickers are from, please just comment below. Sorry, I kind of talked through that. So on Thursday, I wanted to mark Starbucks. I basically used a Alyssa's Craft Shop doily circle every other day. And the days I didn't use that, I used a mini lace box from Bloom Paper Studio. So I just really love that it was really cohesive. And I think I used a flourish every day, pretty much 5 out of the 7 days. And then I used a dot banner from Honey Inked every day too. So I was just really on it. No, I'm looking. Oh, wow. Nope. Okay. I missed one day. It's fine. Okay. So again, this flourish is from Sadie Stickers, this super beautiful latte cup. I'm obsessed with how like amazing this latte cup is from Crafts by Tao. It's so dimensional and 3D. Like it's bomb.com. So good. This planner is from a leftover kit that I had in my stash. So I'm not really sure where it's from, but it's super cute. And I just wanted to mark that I actually filmed my pocket update video. So if you want to watch that, it's on my channel. Just check out my pocket playlist. And what else did I do this day? So I kind of pieced together like a floral piece just to kind of make it look fuller. And I used a lot of the individual florals that came with the kit or with the deco sheet. So instead of using like my own icons to mark working out or going on walks and stuff like that, or just exercising, I tried to use the Converse that came with the kit because I thought that was really cute and fun because they're shoes. So here I'm just gonna, you know, let it hang over the line, and then I'm gonna cut off the excess. And I tucked in some foiled florals and some greenery behind it because it was pretty flat and white. So I just wanted to add some color there. And I did a workout. I also trained, did cardio on the elliptical, which I typically do is I try to do some cardio first to get my heart rate up and just to get some good cardio in. And then I just lift sometimes as well. So I trained chest and triceps this day. I also pulled in some more floral, like what's new. And a lot of these are the meadow accents from Hun Inked. This line divider is also from Sadie Stickers. So at the bottom of Thursday, I wanted to mark that we grabbed some Greek food at this place called Simple Greek with my fiance and his sister and my sister as well. And to be honest, guys, it was not good at all. Like, I really love kava. You guys know I talk about kava all the time. And kava is just definitely so much more fresh and just better tasting in general. So let me know if you've ever been to either and what your thoughts are. But Simple Greek just seemed very, it just wasn't fresh, and there was like really no flavor. Like I felt like they were trying to be Mediterranean, but they were really struggling. Like, I don't know. I go to kava because the food is so fresh and the flavors are amazing, and you get, you know, it's just a greater alternative if you want to go out but still have something pretty healthy and quick on the go. So all right, I should be sponsored by kava. Hey guys, I'm just kidding. Listen, I eat there enough where I get points, so it's fine. Okay, so on Friday, this is the day that we flew to Georgia. So I actually only had one plane icon. Can you guys believe it? Like, I don't have any because I don't buy any because I don't travel lately. But this was off of the Crafts by Taui like summer sampler sheet. So thank goodness I had this. And that is a swatch box from Miss Meow. Really love them. I'm so glad I was able to pull in some colors that matched. And thankfully this like stormy blue was like a perfect color. It kind of matched like the bike and the jeans and some of the full boxes. So it was really, really perfect. And I just tucked in more bouquets here. Another box from Bloom Paper Studio. The sandwich is super cute. That is from Crafts by Taui's foodie sampler as well. I grabbed Starbucks with Alicia, so I used a really cute teacup or a coffee cup, whatever, from White Deer Stationery. I also wanted to make it look like steam was coming out, even though we got cold drinks. We certainly got cold drinks. I don't know the last time I got a hot drink from Starbucks. Let me know, are you like a hot coffee or a cold coffee kind of person when you go to Starbucks or like any coffee shop. Because, yeah, I don't know. You guys know, I love cold coffee. I could drink it all year round, but I also love nitro cold brews and I feel like they're not super cold because they're not iced, you know? They're just kind of chilled. And hot coffee in the summertime, like I just get hot. Like why? Listen, not judging you, but I'm kind of judging you. Why are you drinking hot coffee in the summertime? Aren't you just sweating? Like if you're inside with AC, okay, that's fine. But like, I mean, that's what I do. Gosh, Rachel, you're talking about yourself. What is this voiceover? Oh, ew. I'm so annoying. It's okay. You guys, I'm keeping this in the voiceover. It's fine. Okay. So, oh, I had a really good excuse to use a super cute wagon, and that is also from Crafts by Towie. It was on a sampler to mark that Alicia and I went on a walk with her and her baby. So cute. Loved it. And I had every excuse to use that. I'm glad I had it in gold because I would have been sad if I couldn't use it. We also grabbed some Thai takeout. Since we flew that day, we just wanted to do something easy and really simple. I'm a very chill person, so it's like just, takeout and all that stuff is good. But also the biggest reason why I was able to like really travel this time is because we were all fully vaccinated, and that was something that was really important to us, was just all of us being fully vaccinated and being smart about this. And of course she has a baby, so I just wanted to like to make sure that they were all good too. Okay, so on Saturday, I wanted to mark that I did fasted cardio. She thankfully has like some gym equipment, so I was able to. I'm crazy. So I was up at 6 pretty much every morning, and they were all still sleeping. And I just kind of like did my own thing. I like went on walks. I did some cardio and worked out. And yeah, so I used a treadmill from White Deer Stationery. I also wanted to get ready and actually put makeup on since I had time. So I used a lipstick from White Deer Stationery. I used another circle from Alyssa's Craft Shop to mark that Alicia and I got our nails done this day. So that was really cool. I think I did like a ombre French. Yeah, an ombre French dip set. And we actually got extensions. So that was really, really cool. Or tips. Yeah, I think extensions is for like eyelashes, right? You guys, I don't know. I don't get my eyelashes done. Okay, I rub my eyes way too much and I wear glasses. So there's that. All right, we also grabbed Starbucks. What's new? Oh no, I'm looking at this. I forgot to put the little steamy thingy. Ugh, I gotta go back and do it. Okay, I also wanted to mark that we did Korean barbecue at the house. So, there were so many like Korean places around, and their international markets are phenomenal. So I wanted to mark that we did Korean barbecue at their house, and we had drinks as well. Okay, so for Sunday we just had Starbucks and relaxed, and then we went to an international market and just got some Korean snacks. I actually wanted to snag some Korean snacks for my sister when I went back home, and yeah, so I used that using one of the fancy boxes. This is a really fancy frame geometric box from the Jackson Pepper collab kit that I did with Lena, and really obsessed with how this section turned out. I used a shopping bag from White Deer Stationery, super cute. I always forget that I have them, and they're just like the perfect sized icon, and they're just super simple and so pretty, and I love foiling them. This is going to change because initially I used like a leaf piece from or a vine from Honey Inked, but I really wanted to keep the spread balanced, and I had forgotten to use some of the Letters to Apollo like foiled clusters that are coming from whatever. I forgot to use it on the second half of the week because my planner was flipped, and I used two at the beginning of the week, and it just doesn't look balanced, and I'm kind of mad at myself, but it's fine. It still turned out really pretty. But I wanted to just mark that, and then you'll see it later. But we also grabbed some boba, and this is a really cute boba icon from Rose and Tea Shop. It's the mini version. I don't use it often because I don't get boba too often, truly. So, really great excuse to use that and finally use it. I used another Bloom Paper Studio box, and I was trying to make this large deco floral work, and I was struggling. I was trying to do something different and have like the floral come from the side and not like. Yeah, I don't know. I struggled a lot with this section because I had so many things I wanted to mark, but not enough time. So Alicia and I actually, so we got some Indian food takeout, which was really good. And then Alicia and I made time to do some journaling, which was really cool. And she actually got me some awesome journaling gifts for my birthday. And she's just the sweetest. So I think I hauled that a while back. So if you guys might have seen that. All right, so here are the leftover stickers. This was originally like a talk through for the end, but I really didn't like the sound quality and it was bad. So that's why you might see like my hand gestures and this is a lot slower than usual. But I love how this turned out. So good, and it was refreshing and nice to use gold foil again. So really pretty. But anyways, here is the surprise. So Maria was really kind and sweet and asked if we could do a giveaway for this plan with me, and I was more than happy to do so. So if you want to win a chance to win this amazing kit, I'm actually going to throw in the extra deco sheets that I have just because there's a ton, and I have three of them, and I figured the winner could, have a chance to have all of them and use them as extras. So if you want to enter, please comment below something that you're looking forward to this summer, whether it be a trip you're going on or like just an event or something that you plan on doing this summer. That's just really exciting because, the world is opening back up again. I would love to know and just start a conversation. Also comment giveaway and include your email and or Instagram handle. I need a way to contact you. So if you want to enter, please do all of those things in order to qualify. So thank you again so much, Maria, for hosting this giveaway. It was super kind and generous of you. And again, just so amazing that you even sent me this kit after I spilled water all over it. But I love how this turned out. I hope you did too. Please do not forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Take care of yourselves, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye, everybody.